Welcome to Pacific Update, our weekly news roundup for the region. Coming up, Pasifika teen Josh Nanai tops the US music charts and the controversial Fijian statue. But first, both Guam and French Polynesia continue to grapple with COVID-19 with devastating results. Guam has recorded more than 60 deaths, and there's 13 people currently in intensive care. 92 cases were recorded on just one day this week as the 3,200 plus cases continue to soar. In Tahiti, cases are also climbing at an alarming rate, with around 150 new cases daily. One of those is President Edouard Friche, who tested positive after returning from France. 11 people have died since the country opened its borders without requiring quarantine. Foreign workers entering Papua New Guinea are being fitted with GPS tracking ankle bracelets to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Police Commissioner David Manning says there are large numbers of foreign workers coming into the country. The passengers or companies they work for pay for the cost of the ankle bracelet, which must be worn for the quarantine period. Anyone not complying face up to 5 years in prison. The family of a Tongan fruit picker who died in Australia from a snake bite want his body returned to the kingdom. Timote Ongosia died in Cairns Hospital after being bitten by a brown snake while walking barefoot to his dormitory. The man's wife and family want his body returned, but COVID-19 restrictions have delayed the repatriation. The Pacific has a tough time ahead with La Niña weather pattern being declared. It means countries like Kiribati, Nauru and Tuvalu are likely to experience drought. Higher rainfall is expected to affect all of Melanesia, along with Samoa, Tonga, Southern Cook Islands and Niue. As well as probable flooding, warming sea temperatures could also see more cyclones hitting those areas. Tourist operators in the Cook Islands are hoping for a travel bubble with New Zealand by Christmas. Talks between the two countries have resumed as New Zealand has had no new community spread cases for nearly 3 weeks. New Prime Minister Mark Brown says several points need to be ironed out, including protocols for passengers clearing customs, separation between them and maritime borders and shipping. He says it's likely all passengers would need to provide a negative COVID test. South Auckland-based Pasifika teen Josh Nanai has secured the top spot on the US music charts. The 17-year-old artist, Josh685, collaborated with R&B star Jason Derulo and South Korean boy band BTS to produce a smash hit, a remix of Savage Love. The Samoan Cook Islanders taken to social media, thanking God for the blessing and opportunity to make it happen.
A kid from the South Auckland, you know, just showing all other kids, you can do it from anywhere, any street you're from, anywhere, you know, you can do it. Try. But I still want that, this love, this love.
Defence has sent a 15-strong training team to Fiji to coach and mentor military personnel there as part of a new initiative. The Kiwi team includes those skilled in advanced combat, first aid, an armourer for weapons maintenance and trained shooting coaches. An NZDF psychologist is also part of the team to give advice on selection criteria into the RFMF. The team will be based in Suva and is there until November. And it's been a big week for Fiji, celebrating 50 years of independence. There were impressive scenes at Suva's Albert Park, including a 21-gun salute. And what's an independence celebration without a march, including this one in Lautoka, led by the Ngātamburu High School Brass Band. Social media scorn has been heaped on this strange-looking statue, which was unveiled at the post-Fiji Triangle in Suva. It's since been relocated to the General Post Office. In Samoa, it's that time of the year again, palolo fishing. One night every October, 7 days after the full moon, families head out to the sea for palolo, or the caviar of the Pacific. The edible tail portion of the worm floats to the surface where those patiently waiting grab their fill, best eaten raw or fried with butter and onion. Now to our social media vids of the week. A birthday is a special time to celebrate, but it can go wrong pretty fast. From a happy family scene to one filled with retribution and revenge. And talking of revenge, if you do this prank, expect a swift response. Being ultra flexible is an amazing skill to have, but be aware they don't make high heels like they used to. There's so much to love about this next video. Mum taking son out for a spin, but on a rugby field. Distracted by a chaser, son is immediately forgotten, and then things go south from here. Well, that's it for another week. Stay safe, and I'll be back next Thursday with another Pasifika update.